According to most tech analysts, the Tecno Camon 17 Pro is the best device from the company yet. And I agree. This is because this device is the first in most areas for the company. The first to come with an 8GB of RAM, the first to come with 256GB of internal storage, not the first to come with its 4MP main camera though, but it's definitely the first to come with the 48MP selfie camera up front. So, is this device actually worth the price? Is it the best budget phone you should buy right now? Well, today, the Inside Man will be taking you on another journey to find answers to these questions from the teardown video and inside review of the Camon 17 Pro. With that said, if this is your first time here, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and turn on the post notifications. It's very impressive what Tecno has done with the back plastic of this device. It is strongly glued to the frame of the phone, almost as if this phone is water resistant, even though it's not. However, it's still a good thing for users that the back plastic has a really strong relationship with the frame of the device. But the first turn down for this device is that the back plastic of this device takes lots of fingerprints, which makes it look pretty messy. You know, for a device that actually feels and looks this premium, taking less fingerprints would have been better. Another major concern is that the back plastic also takes scratches, which is why I'd recommend you to use a protective case for the device so that the back won't be looking all messy really. Taking out the screws of this device makes me think of the so many things I would like you guys to see inside the device. For example, the 48MP selfie camera comes off the frame. It's not covered by the frame, which means the sensor is bigger than what the frame could accommodate. Another thing I'd like you guys to see is the rear camera setup, the cooling system of this device, including the battery. This device comes with a MediaTek Helio G95 gaming chipset, which means you can enjoy playing some heavy games with the device. The side-mounted fingerprint scanner is pretty fast. From my testing, it's faster than the in-display fingerprint of the Samsung Galaxy A52. Inside the device, you are greeted by a bunch of tips on top of the components. Tips are not the best way to cool components down, but it's better than nothing. Even the battery of this device is surrounded by tapes, all in an effort to keep the temperature down. The likes of the Galaxy A32 lacks this feature, which is why it gets heated up pretty quickly and can't multitask for long. Another component of this device I'm looking forward to is the speaker of the device. From testing, the speaker of this device is pretty loud. There are two speakers in the device, one at the top and one at the bottom. The top speaker is as big as the bottom, and the sound quality is very impressive, which is why you can rock good sound with the speakers of this device. The bottom board is home to the USB Type-C port, 3.5mm jack, amongst other things. There is a ribbon cable and a network wire attached to the board. The bottom board is pretty normal, and from the look of things, there is no water resistant feature like a gasket or a seal for the 3.5mm jack and USB Type-C ports. But you get a water indicator to help engineers know when the device has come in contact with water. At the bottom right of the board is a vibrator model. Its job in the device is pretty simple and it's good at it. As I said earlier, tips are not the best way to cool down the component of a device, but it's still better than nothing. And to take out the battery, I have to remove ribbon cables and a network wire to make removing the battery very easy. The battery of this device is 5000 mAh battery and comes with a 25W fast charger. I have not always been good friends with pull tabs, and I just don't know why they don't like me. This is why I always refer to my tools and pry out the battery. It's not the best way of taking out the battery, but it gets the job done pretty well. The battery is pretty decent. While playing games with the phone or doing some heavy task, it can take you for a day and a half. Sometimes it can take you 2 days, which in my books is pretty nice. But it's not just about the long-lasting battery. I'm also interested in the cooling system for the battery. And beneath the battery is a graphite cooling system that helps keep the temperature of the battery down under heavy usage. Not just one, but two graphite cooling systems for the battery, which is really good. I mean, the Infinix Note 10 Pro I tore down a few days back only come with one of these. This means that playing games extensively or under heavy usage, the battery of this device can and will maintain its cool for a long time. You won't have to worry about the battery temperature, like what we saw in Samsung Galaxy A32, where there's hardly any cooling system for the battery, which makes the device to easily get hot and multitasking becomes a problem. And even in some cases, the Galaxy A32 can split screen due to high temperature notification. Two more screws out and I can take out the top motherboard. Now, the top motherboard is host to most of the components of the device. The CPU is here, the GPU is here, the ISP is here, the cameras and the SIM card tray. With the numbers of jobs, it's only fair if the CPU, the top board, is properly cooled. The top board is very easy to remove, but I noticed that the 14 megapixel camera sensor is so big that it's tightly tucked inside the camera selfie hook. I'll tell you more about the cameras in a bit, but first let's talk about the cooling for the chipset. The chipset has pink thermal paste and also covered with copper. The 64 megapixel main camera does not have wires and is accompanied by 8 megapixel ultra wide, 2 megapixel depth sensor and 2 megapixel macro lens. The 14 megapixel selfie camera is big. It's bigger than most of the selfie cameras I've seen in phones I've turned down in the channel. Taking it out and doing a side-by-side comparison with the 64 megapixel main camera just to see, you'll see that it's really big. Yes, the 14 megapixel is really big. It's not as big as the 64 megapixel main camera, but the 14 megapixel camera is as big as some of the cameras you see in the back of some devices, even bigger than some of the cameras you see in the back devices. So this is the Tecno Camon 17 Pro from the inside, and it's surprisingly good. The rear and front cameras of this device can record 4K videos, and this is one reason why most photo freaks might like this device. Then there is an efficient cooling system for the device, coming with the Helio G95 gaming chipset. Tecno really did well to make sure the chipset won't get heated up quickly. It also have good battery life. Battery can last you up to 1.5 days under heavy usage, and the battery is also properly cooled. And the price of the device is around $310, which is way cheaper than what other brands are offering. It's a device designed for everyone, photo lovers, gamers, movie watchers, you name it. The only downside to this device is that there is no official news from Tecno Mobile if the phone will get major software update. This is one reason why most users won't buy this device. Aside from the software update issues, this device is easily the best budget smartphone you can buy right now. Alright, don't forget to hit the subscribe button below if you haven't done so, and also follow me on my social media accounts. Twitter, Instagram at TechRan. It's me, the Inside Man from TechRan, and I'll see you guys in my next one. For now, tell you guys adios and stay safe. See you.